Hello, my name is Barry Lefer, a program scientist in NASA's Earth Science Division. Today I would like to show you how scientists are using the OMI instrument to track changes in air quality during COVID. The Ozone Monitoring Instrument, or OMI, was primarily designed to observe the Earth's stratospheric ozone layer. The instrument works by measuring the intensity of reflected sunlight at various wavelengths and detects the absorption features of various atmospheric trace gases, including ozone, nitrogen dioxide, sulfur dioxide, and formaldehyde. The OMI instrument's wide swath and the Aura satellite's orbit allows OMI to observe the entire Earth each day at approximately 1:30 in the afternoon. Because OMI is measuring reflected sunlight, it cannot detect pollution below clouds. This global NO2 map shows the annual average for 2005, the first full year of OMI nitrogen dioxide data. The red areas on the map are the regions with the highest levels of NO2, places such as the northeastern United States, northern Europe, eastern China, and even northeastern South Africa. Nitrogen dioxide is produced by fossil fuel combustion, activities such as the burning of gasoline or diesel in automobiles and trucks, and combusting natural gas or coal in electric power plants. NO2 is highly reactive, and so it only lasts a couple of hours in the atmosphere. And as a result, NO2 maps give us a good picture of where the pollution is generated. NO2 is harmful to human health and reacts to form other harmful pollutants such as ozone and particulate matter. The next slide is the same type of data, except for 10 years later. This map is the annual OMI NO2 data for 2014. And if you look carefully, you can see that the NO2 levels in the northeastern U.S. have decreased considerably. In addition, the NO2 levels in China have increased. Now I'm going to go back to the 2005 map so you can see this change one more time. Here's the 2005 OMI NO2 map again. Take a close look at the eastern U.S. as I go back to 2014. So here is the 2014 map, and the eastern U.S. has cleaned up considerably. Europe has slightly less NO2, but China and India are emitting more than they were in 2005. It's difficult to see these regional changes on the global maps, so let's zoom into the eastern U.S. Both of these figures of the eastern half of the United States are showing data from 2005. The top map shows NO2 data, and the bottom map is sulfur dioxide, or SO2, data. SO2 is primarily produced from the burning of coal. Now I'm going to jump forward in time 15 years to 2019, and you can easily see that both NO2 and SO2 have cleaned up dramatically. This is a result of the Clean Air Act. Catalytic converters in cars really do work, resulting in less SO2. And the pollution scrubbers on coal power plants do a good job of preventing NO2 and SO2 from being emitted to the atmosphere. The next plot is showing the full annual time series from 2005 to 2019 for the area inside the black box on the map. This is the central part of the Ohio River Valley. As you can now see, NO2 levels rapidly dropped in this region of coal power plants in the first few years of the record, and then leveled off at about a 50% reduction. The SO2, however, continued to drop a few more years and eventually reached more than an 80% reduction from the 2005. These are similar 2005 OMI NO2 and SO2 maps, except for Asia. Now I'm showing the same maps for 2019. What is interesting is the NO2 levels have not really changed that much over that 15-year period, but the SO2 is almost all gone. If we take a closer look at the annual time series for the area inside the black box in northeastern China, you will see that the blue time series line shows that NO2 levels in this region rose until 2011, and then come back down to the original NO2 emission levels a few years later. The red SO2 time series for northeastern China shows a very different trend. SO2 dropped almost every year and has been reduced by almost 90% by 2019. Here are the same plots for India, Pakistan, Nepal, Sri Lanka, and most of Myanmar. In the 2005 plots, the red dots in India are regions with coal power plants. If we look at 2019, the SO2 and NO2 pollution from these areas of India have increased. The dots have gotten bigger. The annual time series plots from 2005 to 2019 for the area inside the black box in northeast India shows that these coal power plants have continued to emit increasing amounts of NO2 and SO2 year after year until very recently. India has a severe air quality problem, so it should not be surprising that India now emits more SO2 in the atmosphere than any other country. Nevertheless, it is quite encouraging to see that India has started to try and scrub the pollution from these power plants. Now that you have seen the incredible value of this long-term global OMI NO2 dataset, I want to shift to what happened in 2020. Here's the global NO2 map for February 2020. By itself, it is hard to see what has changed. So now let's take a look at what NO2 levels are for a quote-unquote normal February. The NO2 levels for a given week or a given month can change due to differences in weather, i.e. if it is unusually hot or cold or windy or rainy. So to make a more meaningful comparison, we are going to use the 5-year average of all the Februaries between 2015 and 2019. We will call this 5-year average the NO2 baseline. Now I'm going to switch back to February 2020 and see if you can detect any changes. The primary change was a big decrease in NO2 pollution over China. In late January, China was the first country to go into a COVID lockdown, and OMI does a good job of capturing that decrease. A slightly easier way to look at the global NO2 changes in 2020 is to subtract the 2020 values from the baseline levels. In this NO2 difference map, you can clearly see the large NO2 decreases in China, with much of the rest of the world showing mostly normal levels of NO2. Here's the February 2020 OMI NO2 difference map for East Asia, with a large decrease for China. And on the right is the NO2 difference map for March 2020 for the same region. By March, the first COVID lockdown for China was over, and the NO2 levels are pretty much back to normal. Now I am showing the February 2020 NO2 difference map for the US and Mexico. And it looks like the eastern half of the US is mostly blue, or in other words, slightly lower than normal. But Monterrey, Mexico seems a bit higher than average. By March 2020, more of the eastern US is blue. New York and Long Island are dark blue. And Los Angeles is clearly lower than normal. By April 2020, you can now see that NO2 levels in Chicago and the Lake Michigan region are lower, and the same for Denver and Los Angeles. And in Mexico, it's easy to see a large NO2 reduction in Mexico City and also for Monterrey. These changes in NO2 emissions can be correlated with traffic and mobility data collected by Google and Apple based on people's cell phone movements. For the last part of my talk, I want to familiarize you with the NASA OMI NO2 dashboard for COVID air quality data. This is what the homepage looks like if you were to click on the web address on the right. One of the most exciting features about this OMI dashboard map is that it updates every day. Every day, the difference between 2020 and the 5-year baseline is calculated for hundreds of cities around the world. And the color of the symbol for each city represents the percent change in the NO2 for 2020. If you were to click on Lima, Peru, you would see these three maps. The left map is the current 2020 15-day average for Lima. The middle map is the baseline map for the same days. And the right is the difference plot. In this case, NO2 levels inside a 1-degree by 1-degree box around Lima are 23% lower for 2020. Thank you for your attention. I wanted to leave you with a list of links to some COVID dashboards. I also have included my email. Don't hesitate to reach out to me. Take care and have a nice AGU.